Well, the basic idea of it is that I left the Chesapeake Bay, sailed up between Canada and Greenland to the polar ice cap, so you can't sail any further north. And then you hang a left and go through the Canadian archipelago, which is the Northwest Passage. Then you have to sail around the entire state of Alaska. And of course, for the whole northern section of that, which is like 1,200 miles, you're 1,000 miles north of where they filmed The Deadliest Catch. So you think it's bad down there, I'm 1,000 miles north of that for like 1,000 miles. But anyways, eventually you get down to Bering Sea, out into the open Pacific, and then you gotta sail the entire Pacific Ocean down to Cape Horn, which is about 400 miles from Antarctica, and then around Cape Horn, back up the Atlantic. The whole thing was 27,000 miles, and it took me 309 days. Well, 310 days is what I said. Technically, I was 5 hours and 30 minutes off, because it was 309 days, 18 hours, 38 minutes, or something along those lines. So yeah, I was only off by about 5.5 hours. But, you know, I can't, you know, how much of that is luck and how much, I planned it out at 23,000 miles at 3 knots, but it ended up being 27,000 miles because nobody had ever done it. There's no real, nothing to go off of, you know, like if you go around the world, you can say, well, this guy did this and this guy did that and that's how long it's going to take. But since someone only ever did this trip, you know, I just kind of threw it out there, but it was a pretty good guess. You know, I was only off by a little bit. The, you know, sailing the coast of Greenland, you get tons of icebergs, tons of fog. The combination of icebergs and fog is a very dangerous situation because it's super pea soup fog and you're surrounded by ice all over the place. The Northwest Passage, of course, also, it's, you know, 30 some degrees. You're always fighting to get blood in your hands and toes. I don't have a heater on this boat, of course, so I'm just trying to keep myself warm, but you're wet all the time too from the fog. So it's cold and wet. It's not just cold. You know, your sleeping bag's wet for 2 months, your pillow's wet, you crawl into a wet sleeping bag at night. At night, the sun doesn't go down, so you can't tell the difference between night and day. Alaska, of course, has giant waves. I almost flipped this boat upside down by a wave. Well, a wave almost flipped me upside down. But you expect that in Alaska. And then, you know, the equator, where you have the easterly trades, you get pretty much steady winds, but they're usually in your face. And Cape Horn is Cape Horn. You're going to get giant waves and big storms and, you know, the appropriate Cape Horn weather. The problem is all financial. It's, if money wasn't an option, then I could have all this, that, and all the fancy stuff. But since money is a problem, then, you know, a lot of this equipment I had to rip off my boat. A lot of this had crossed the ocean a couple times before this trip, you know? So, I mean, this is old stuff to begin with. We just couldn't raise enough money to refit the boat and get all new electronics and new this and new that. But, I don't know what I'd bring with. Maybe a girlfriend. I don't have to sail alone no more.
Loneliness had to be bad.
Yeah, loneliness comes and goes. You know, you just accept your environment and accept your situation. But yes, it can come and go. But
well, I know you crossed the finish line of the actual historical part, which is the circumnavigation of the Western Hemisphere. Mm-hmm. And so that's behind you. You've had a day or two to relax, maybe get a night's sleep. But you're on your way to finally step on land again after almost 11 months. What's going through your mind?
Well, it would be nice to actually get back on land, tie this boat off, and kind of be done with it, you know? Like, a shower would be nice. Like, you probably can't tell. You might be able to see, like, the constant exposure to a saltwater environment eats your skin. And I got red spots on my face that are not going to go away until I can start getting fresh water in me. I've been dumping buckets of salt water over my head for, you know, the whole time, 300 and some odd days. So it's, it would be nice to take a shower and relax. It's a bit overwhelming, the idea of the next couple of hours necessarily, you know, trying to get there exactly at noon and even though it's not that far, but, you know, and then whatever else is going to happen down there, I don't know. But, it'd be nice like 2 or 3 days from now when things calm down a bit and, I kind of go back to a normal-ish life.